left sharks, Amy sharks, Aussie sharks.
Hello, name's Bruce.
Baby sharks. Big whoop, how about a week of sharks? Launched way back in 1988, the Discovery Channel's Shark Week quickly transcended its humble fact-based origins.
That's Shark Week.
Jumping the proverbial with awesomely bonkers moments like Michael Phelps racing a virtual shark.
The great white shark takes the gold.
Since then, it's silently glided into pop culture.
Live every week like a Shark Week.
And even presidential scandals.
I remember arriving and he was watching Shark Week. He made me sit and watch an entire documentary about shark attacks.
But this year, it's back to basics. Random celebrities getting scared out of their minds.
Shark tried to kill me, America.
And majestic toothy fish just doing their thing. Oh, and if you're wondering how sharks have handled COVID-19 for some reason, they've even got that covered too.
Because there are no humans on the ocean, sharks are actually behaving a little bit differently. They are bolder.
Like sharks, Clarke Gayford, yes, that Clarke Gayford, is most at home in the ocean.
I've spent my whole life looking for excuses to get out on the water, and most importantly, get under the water.
So what did New Zealand's first fella find down there?
Clarke Gayford is a seafarer and broadcaster. Clarke, forgive me for thinking that you were possibly the least stressed person in your relationship. Turns out you swim with sharks.
I mean, everyone needs a hobby, I guess.
So just talk us through that. You're in the middle of this super strict lockdown and you think, oh, gee, I wonder how the sharks are handling all this. Is that what happened?
Yeah, it's pretty much what happened. Just to clarify, I didn't go during the super strict lockdown. I was right at the tail end of the super strict lockdown. But yeah, it's a remarkable sort of period in the world, really, where we have this control environment. And for us, no boats on the water means no sound. And so we were keen to go out and see, you know, good excuse to see if that affected fish life behaviour.
And did it? What did you learn?
Well, we'd heard lots of anecdotal stories. We'd seen lots of big schools of fish coming closer to shore, stories of sharks around moored boats, a few people that had gone out on kayaks getting the odd fright. And so we went right down south where there'd been no boat activity. And, we found a lot of sharks that seemed like they missed us.
We spoke to your fiancée, Jacinda, just a couple of months ago. Here's what she said about life in lockdown.
We had toddler with us as well and just... We didn't have playgrounds open and things like that. So it was just those simple things of trying to keep the family entertained and active.
All right, be honest. Is that what the documentary was really about? Was she just trying to get you out of the house?
Trying to get myself out of the house. It was a wonderful juxtaposition, though, to go from, managing a toddler and sort of speaking in very basic language and that, and then suddenly, after a plane flight and a small drive, to be dealing with these large grey white sharks up close. Quite the contrast.
It has been a hell of a year. How's the family coped throughout?
Yeah, we had a few things to get through. Haven't really honestly taken the break this year, and we sort of dangled Christmas as this sort of goal on the horizon. So the idea is just to get there.
Well, 2021 has a nice ring to it, maybe even for wedding bells. Is the plans starting to come along, Clarke?
The plans did start to come along and then we just went, well, we've had this happen and this happen, and then you realise we should be trying to get married at some point and, oh, it's just starting to get a bit hard. It will happen, but just sometime in the future.
Hey, Clarke, I just wanted to say I get it, mate. I've dived with sharks as well, and so I'm so sorry you've had to put up with these questions from these land lovers over here, but let's really do a bit of shark chat. Did you pee in your wetsuit as well?
Oh dear, did I? It's hard to, the water was so cold I was numb. I mean, it's still debatable whether I did or not. Who knows?
If you say it's debatable, it means you definitely did. Did you find any of these experiences scary, or is it all kind of relaxing and nice being out there in nature?
Look, I love any excuse to get out on the ocean. Going down into that environment with great whites did kind of ruin me a little bit, though. As an active spearfisher, I have tangled with sharks kind of the whole time I've been in the water, but nothing that big. And so when you do get up close, there is something distant and dormant in your DNA that springs into life that says, danger, danger, get out of the way.
Is this a real ad for just how hard it is being a new parent, that you would rather go and dive with a great white shark?
yeah, there was parts of it that perhaps felt, you know, just a little bit like a holiday.
I wasn't sure if it was for the holiday or you just wanted to swim with sharks to, I don't know, see what Jacinda feels like when she's in Parliament.
a lot of comparisons there, absolutely. Although, I mean, with the great white, you know what it's thinking. It's not hiding behind sort of, you know, double speak and platitudes and doing the numbers behind your back. You actually know what that great white wants to do to you if you got out of the cage.
That is true. I heard politicians, though, can also smell blood from up to 10K away.
Oh, man, and they work in a pack. They circle and operate as one at times. Not my world.
I did see the rest of the programming for Shark Week, and it's got some pretty amazing stuff there. There's one show I'm sure you must have been shattered you missed out on. It was Naked and Afraid of Sharks 2.
Yeah, it's not on my to-do list. You certainly wouldn't have done it where we went. Well, in fact, if you did, they wouldn't have had to spend much on blurring and post, that's for sure.
Are you saying you weren't offering up the biggest bait?
That was, when you go into survival mode, sort of, you know, you retract to your core, all of you.
I can understand swimming with sharks is scary, but it's probably more scary for your loved ones who aren't there. Was Jacinda worried, genuinely worried?
She hasn't seen it. So, you know, we just smooth around the edges and, it was just, you know, fishing trip down south.
Mate, right. After what I've seen of most relationships in lockdown, she was probably hoping you got taken.
No, she needed someone. And look, when you've got a two-year-old, it is all hands to the pump. I was sorely missed.
Well, Shark Week kicks off next Thursday, 9:30 on the Discovery Channel. Clarke, thank you so much for chatting with us today.
Good to be able to understand you. That sort of, you know, that distance and those accents, it works.